Hello! Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3. Can y'all hear me? Just kidding, this doesn't work. I might use this just to pretend. So I already did my eyebrows and I prepped my lids using the 24-hour extended eye base. And for my brows, I use the brow powder duo from the Anastasia. And then I'm just gonna set it with the MAC Prolongwear waterproof brow set. Okay, for some reason I thought I was gonna do a voiceover, but it's not a voiceover. So using the 224, I will be using the Subculture Palette and going in with the color Dawn. And this is gonna act as our transition color. I'm gonna do fudge. And I'm putting this right on top of Dawn to deepen up the crease. With the 217 brush, I'm gonna use All Star here. And this is gonna be going into the outer V. And then using the 221 brush, deepen up the outer corner a little bit more. I'll be using the Carbon eyeshadow from MAC. And going back with the 224 just to blend out the edges. That way we don't have any harsh lines. And then using the 214 brush, going back in with All Star. Just kind of pack it on right in here. Just to start having that transition from light to dark. And then softly buff out the edges. And then I'll be using Red Brick from MAC. Same 214 brush. And apply it right on the lid. And then going back to the Subculture palette, I'm gonna go in with Roxy here. And this is gonna go on the inner corner of the eye to brighten that up. For my liner, I'm gonna be using the BrushBlack Brushstroke liner from MAC. I'm going to be using the Extended Play Mascara from MAC. The reason why I like this one is because it grabs onto every single lash of mine. And I barely have any lashes. They're like baby lashes. And I just do one coat of that. Because we're going to be putting some lashes. And then for my lashes, I'm going to be using the 34s by MAC. So we're gonna let these guys sit. In the meantime, I will be doing the rest of my face. Okay, so for my foundation, I will be using the Designer Lift foundation from Armani. And this is in the color 4.5. And then just using my beauty blender. This foundation gives you like a soft filter and it's hydrating, it's plumping, everything that you need in the winter. My skin gets so dry in the winter and this is what I need every time. And because it's so lightweight, I like to use the beauty blender because then the brushes absorb it. This absorbs the product as well, but I feel like it gives me more of like that soft satin finish that I like. Bring it down to your papada. And then around my nose, I'll just go in with the 286 brush. Just to softly buff it in. just so it doesn't look disconnected. And I like to skip my eye area as well. Look like a raccoon for like a minute or two. Okay, and then as you probably guessed, I will be using the Prolongwear concealer in NC20 to set my under eyes. And to set that, I'm gonna be using the Laura Mercier translucent powder and then just using my beauty blender. Tap really lightly. And then since this foundation is very moisturizing, I do have these fine lines when I smile, if I ever smile, just kidding. But you can see it's already setting into that crease right here. So I'm just gonna apply a little bit right in there. And then whatever's left, just gonna set it into the rest of where I put the highlighter. And then I'm just gonna remove it. And then we want to set the rest of the face, and I'm going to be using the Next to Nothing powder. I'll use the 140 synthetic brush and then just softly apply it. And then again, emphasizing on those lines. And then we are going to contour our face. For that, I'm going to be using the Marc Jacobs. This one is the Tantastic. I've been obsessed with this brush lately because it's really soft and it bends into your contours, into the contours of your face. This is the 137 brush. And I'm just going to start chiseling your cheekbones. It doesn't give you like any harsh lines. It just adds and lays the product softly without overdoing it. And then whatever's left. And then using that same brush, using my favorite blush. Everybody knows this by now. Just softly buff it in. And then for highlighter, I'm using the Jouer in Citrine with the Anastasia brush. This poor powder has been through hell. Ooh, I almost forgot. So we're actually going to add this Liquid Glow by Anastasia. This one is the indie color Pearl, or Perla, just a teeny tiny bit. To the top of our cheekbones. Just tap it in. And then we'll add our highlighter. And then going back to the eyes, we are using the Costa Riche liner from MAC to tighten up that waterline. Okay, so my camera keeps warming up, so I don't know where I left off. I let it cool for about 30 minutes. So, oh, I was doing my eyes. So I did the Costa Riche liner. And then with the 217 brush, I'm gonna grab a little bit of that, or the 214 brush, sorry. I'm gonna grab a little bit of that black. And then with the 239 brush, I'm gonna go back in with Red Brick from MAC. And then with the 221 brush, I'm gonna go in with Roxy from the Anastasia palette. So it's a little too light for my liking. So I'm gonna go in with All Star. And then put it right under where we put that black shadow. feel like it's super matte, so let's see what we got. We'll just put a little bit of the Jouer highlighter on the inner corner. I can open it. There we go. We're gonna highlight the nose. The Cupid's bow. And then for lips, I'm gonna use the liquid lipstick by Kat Von D in Lolita. So I'm gonna do the Mariah Carey lip gloss. And that, guys, concludes this video. This look is inspired on Thanksgiving. I hope you all enjoy your Thanksgiving with your family members, and I'll see you guys on my next video. Bye.